ladies and gentlemen, the Kingston Trio.
I came to this country in 1957 as a refugee from Hungary. It was the music, the rhythm that got me to the Kingston Trio, and that's how I learned English. Ever since, I've been singing those songs.
I grew up in Macon, Georgia in the 1960s. This was the highlight of my high school life, really, was listening to them sing. I've been a fan ever since.
As far as I was concerned, they were great. I wanted to sound like them and have shirts like them, which we did. We've come from Wales, by the way.
The Beatles opened the shows for us in England before they came over here. We tour all year, every year, for 45 years.
On behalf of the World Folk Music Association, welcome to the Kingston Trio 45th anniversary tribute. You're in for a night you'll remember for a long time. To get things underway, we got a wonderful lineup, great talent, including the guy we're going to introduce right now as your master of ceremonies. Funny guy, please welcome Ronnie Schell.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. Thank you. Dick, I'll just need this one mic. You can take these other ones. I don't need that many. Thanks anyway. Told you I'd pack them in. It is a pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, really a real pleasure for me to take time out of my very heavy schedule of eating and sleeping to be here tonight. As Dick told you, I still work Las Vegas. I work there twice a year up at Harrah's, and after all these years, he said, well, for this particular event, please don't do any dirty jokes. Cut out all the blue material and all the sick humor from your regular nightclub repertoire. I said, I'd be very happy to. So in conclusion, I've got to tell you. Actually, I have to tell you just a bit. It'll take about, an hour. No, I just take a few minutes to tell you a little bit of how I got into this particular situation tonight. Dick came out. I live in Los Angeles, California. You live in L.A. Can I get a lift home? Los Angeles, of course, is a wonderful city on the West Coast, a city of 4 million people, 1,500 English-speaking, and anyway, he came out there, and he came out to my house, and he said, listen, we're doing a big tribute to the Kingston Trio. I know you started with them at the Purple Onion in San Francisco, and you toured with them for 2.5 years. Would you like to be the MC? And I said, well, you know, I've done so well since I left the trio that I would need a very large salary. I'd need to at least $10,000 for the two nights. And Dick was very nice about it. He smiled and gave me the peace sign. Well, part of it anyway. And I didn't know any different. I thought, well, I'm still number one. But he drew up a contract for less money. I said, no, I need $10,000 or I don't show up. So we talked and we chatted, and finally I signed the contract and settled for less. I figured, why ruin a friendship over $9,800? Besides, he said that he would treat me royally, and he did. We arrived at Dulles Airport, my wife and my two little kids, and before he brought us here to Arlington, he took us into downtown D.C. for free coffee and donuts. And my kids were quite thrilled. They'd never given blood before. Thanks for that, Dick. All right, why don't we get the show started? Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, the great Limelighters. Let's hear it for them.
Here's some of America's oldest folk songs. Alan Lomax first collected these in the 1930s, and from an old man who had gotten them from his grandfather, who heard them from a ship's captain, who had gotten them traditionally from gypsies from Eastern Europe, passed down over generations to one old shepherd who had learned them from a Kingston Trio album.
Some hard traveling I thought you know I've been doing some hard traveling way down the road. For my journey now, Mount Zion, I've been hitting that Lincoln Highway. I thought you know, I've been hitting that 66 way down the road. Heavy load and a worried mind, looking for a woman that's hard to find. I've been doing some hard traveling, Lord. On my journey now to Mount Zion, on my journey now to Mount Zion, on my journey now to Mount Zion.
Journey now to Mount Zion, my time is near. The road is hard and the road is long, I have no fear. On my journey now to Mount Zion, where the lamb lies down with the lion. I've been doing some hard traveling, Lord.
I've been doing some hard traveling, I thought you know. I've been doing some hard traveling way down the road. I've been doing some hard rambling, I've been
sickness, no toil or danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going there to see my father. I'm going there no more to roam. I'm going these mornings, and it won't be long.
It won't be long.
All men will rise, stand side by side, and hand in hand, we're bound for glory. All foes will fall before freedom's time. Jordan, I'm going there to my new home.
To my new home. I'm going there to see my mother. I'm going there no more to roam. I'm going there
just Jordan, I'm going there to my new home.
My new home.
I am a poor wayfaring stranger.
And a lonesome traveler, I am a weary and a lonesome traveler. I am a weary and a lonesome traveler. I've been a traveling on.
I've traveled here and I have traveled yonder. I've traveled near and I have traveled yonder. I've traveled near and I have traveled yonder. I've been a traveling on.
I've traveled cold and I have traveled hungry, Lord. I've traveled cold and I have traveled hungry, Lord. I've traveled cold and I have traveled hungry, Lord. I've been a traveling on.
I've traveled in the mountains, traveled down in the valleys, Lord. I've traveled in the mountains, traveled down in the valleys, Lord. I've traveled in the mountains, traveled down in the valleys, Lord. I've been a traveling on.
And I've traveled with the rich and traveled with the poor. Traveled with the rich and traveled with the poor.
Traveled with the rich and traveled with the poor. I've been a traveling on. One of these days I'm gonna stop all my traveling. One of these days I'm gonna stop all my traveling. One of these days I'm gonna stop all my traveling. Stop all my traveling.
That, of course, was a medley of the sorts of songs that brought us perilously close to solvency in times past. All right, this is our 43rd year as a band, ladies and gentlemen.
We are very pleased to be part of this wonderful evening of music to honor, of course, one of the most influential bands in the history of folk music, the Kingston Trio. So we're very happy to be here. You know, we, the Limelighters, have always prided ourselves on remaining current by adding new songs to our repertoire as the times dictated. And just recently, we found a song so compelling, so in tune with the times, that we couldn't resist putting it into the show immediately. And we especially love it because it sounds exactly like one of our old songs. Here it is.
This is our up-tempo folk song, the one we use to start the show. Our up-tempo folk song, the kind every folk singer ought to know. The kind that sets your toes a-tapping and makes you want to sing along. The one we stole from the Kingston Trio, a generic up-tempo folk song. This is the middle of our up-tempo folk song. It's called the second verse. You gotta sing it warm and tender to make it sound different from the first. This is where we look at all the people just to see who is around. And if we sing the second verse softly, the crowd usually quiets down. This is the bridge and it's really exciting. It has a different blend. The purpose of the bridge is to get from the middle to the beginning of the end of this, our up-tempo folk song. The end is drawing near, and by now you're so gosh darn excited, you want to stand right up and cheer and say hooray for the folk survivors. May they sing forever strong. And for the land of the brave and free, generic up-tempo folk song. Ah. And say hooray for the folk survivors. May they sing forever strong. May they shed a tear each time they hear a generic up-tempo folk song.
But wait, we forgot the Limelighter ending.
Oh, yeah.
A generic up-tempo folk song.
But folk
the way it used to be thought of back in the 40s and the 50s has changed a great deal. It's not what it used to be. It used to be a union movement and a lot of it, in the urban folk movement. And I think that's changed a good deal. On the other hand, folk music continues to point out the anomalies, the discrepancies within society, because folk music is about the truth of life, not just about Moon, June, Spoon. And that will never change.
We've been accused over the years of being old folkies, and we're here to put that to rest, really. We think we have found the song that will take folk music to the new generation. Yo, folkies.
Yo.
Yo.
Head down, honky white boy. Now give me that guitar. I'll show you how to use it. I play a funky thing that they call folk music. The Kingston Trio, Serendipity, and Peter, Paul, and Mary, now just to name three. They sung about the dead, the big Grand Canyon. They used to make a lot of cash for Perry Home Companion. Anglo-Saxon, Protestant, white, and a hoot nanny, Saturday night, doing folk rap. Yeah, can you dig it? A folk rap. Yeah, a boogie down, boogie, folk rap. Yeah, Woody Guthrie, a folk rap. Hey, listen to me now, the crew war is raging. Johnny has to go, don't you let me go. When you say no, Johnny, no, Johnny, no. If you miss the train, I'm on, you know that I am gone. You can hear the whistle blow 100 miles. Huh, Michael, row the boat ashore.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Michael, row the boat ashore.
Hallelujah.
Hey, if I had a hammer,
I'd hammer in the morning, I'd hammer in the evening, I'd hammer in your face. Puff, 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 puff.
I bust the magic dragon, he lived by the sea. Pollock in the waters in Alaskan holiday. A little Jackie Pickle, he loved that rascal Puff. Jackie spit the scene. Out in the hobbies doing folk rap.
Yeah, can you dig it?
A folk rap.
Yeah,
boogie down, boogie
folk rap.
Yeah,
boogie woogie,
a folk rap.
Yeah,
kumbaya.
Stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the very famous and very wonderful Shaw Brothers. Let's hear it for them.
Good evening. Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. I cleared the rocks and timber from the wild New England shore. I labored long and hard to make it grow. I built the first log cabin and I raised a family. Old King George and all his redcoats, where to go? I'm the man that built the bridges, I'm the man that laid the track. I'm the man that built this country with my shoulders and my back. I'm the man that built the power dams and oiled all the cars. And I laid down the cornerstone for this great land of ours. I'm the boy that drove the wagons when the people headed west, dug canals and pulled the barges on their way. I built and ran the factories, cut the timber for your home, drove the oxen when I cut and baled the hay. I'm the man that built the bridges, I'm the man that laid the track. I'm the man that built this country with my shoulders and my back. I'm the man that built the power dams and boiled all the cars. And I laid down the cornerstone for this great land of ours. I built the old sod shanties and I raised the prairie towns. I made the railroad run from sea to sea. I raised and drove the cattle to feed a growing land. And the mining towns up there because of me. I'm the man that built the bridges. I'm the man that laid the track. I'm the man that built this country with my shoulders and my back. I'm the man that built the power dams and oiled all the cars. And I laid down the cornerstone for this great land of ours. I built the old sod shanties and I raised the prairie towns. I made the railroad run from sea to sea. I raised and drove the cattle to feed a growing land. And the mining towns up there because of me. I'm the man that built the bridges. I'm the man that laid the track.
I'm the man that built this country with my shoulders and my back. I'm the man that built the power dams and oiled all the cars. And I laid down the cornerstone for this great land of ours. Now my face may not be pretty and my clothes are not the best, and there ain't no big shots in my family tree. But if you're wondering who it was that made this country great, you don't have to look no further, it was me. I'm the man that built the bridges, I'm the man that laid the track. I'm the man that built this country with my shoulders and my back. I'm the man that built the power dams and oiled all the cars. And I laid down the cornerstone for this great land of ours. I'm the man that built the bridges, I'm the man that laid the track. I'm the man that built this country with my shoulders and my back. I'm the man that built the power dams and oiled all the cars. And I laid down the cornerstone for this great land of ours.
Thank you very, very much. Let me say what a pleasure it is to be here this evening on this very special occasion. We are the Shaw Brothers, and I just want to take a moment to introduce ourselves to you so you'll know who's who. To my immediate left is my brother, Ron. Thank you, Ron. That's Ron Shaw over there. My name is Rick Shaw, okay? I swear it's true. If you're going to laugh, go ahead, get it out of your systems. People ride me about it all the time. Get a lot of mileage out of it, though. During the course of our brief presentation here, we're going to mix it up a little bit and do some songs that are sort of representative of who we are and where we've come from. And certainly, over the years, the Kingston Trio have been a great influence to us, as have the Brothers Four and the Limelighters and the other people you'll be seeing on stage tonight. But we also have our own roots that we draw from. And some years ago, Ron and I were recording with RCA Victor Records, and we recorded an album for RCA, which bore the title of the song that came from that album as a single. And this was back in the 1970s, and that song is still played on the better radio stations around the country.
Haven't heard it in years.
If you haven't heard it, you haven't been listening to the better radio stations. But it does have a chorus, and you're more than welcome to join us on it.
It's by far the hardest thing I've ever done, to be so in love with you and so alone. Follow me where I go, what I do and who I know. Make it part of you to be a part of me. Follow me up and down, all the way and all around. Take my hand and I will follow too. It's long been on my mind, you know it's been a long, long time. I've tried to find a way that would make you understand the way I feel about you and just how much I need you to be there where I can talk with you when there's no one else around. Follow me where I go, what I do and who I know. Make it part of you to be a part of me.
Everybody sing.
Follow me up and down, all the way and all around.
That's it.
Take my hand and I will follow too.
You see, I'd like to share my life with you and show you things I've seen, places where I'm going to, places where I've been. To have you there beside me and never feel alone, and all the time that you're with me, then we will be at home.
Follow me where I go, what I do part of you, to be a part of me. Follow me up and down, all the way and all around. Take my hand and I will follow too. Take my hand and I will follow too.
Well, I'll tell you, we were at the University of New Hampshire in the late 1950s when folk music a la the Kingston Trio in particular really broke, and it swept us all up. We all had an interest to begin with in this type of music, but all of a sudden there was an interest generally across the country, and we just picked up on it, and we've been riding that wave, and it's still going.
In 1972, we were members of a large group of 9 people called the Hillside Singers, and we recorded the Coca-Cola song. We did. I'd like to teach the world to sing.
I'd like to build the world a home and furnish it with love. Grow apple trees and honeybees and snow-white turtle doves. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. I'd like to hold it in my arms and keep it company. I'd like to see the world for once all standing hand in hand and hear them echo through the hills for peace throughout the land. It's the real thing, what the world wants today. That's the way it'll stay, with the real thing.
That's the chorus, try it again.
It's the real thing.
You get it.
What the world wants today,
that's the way it'll stay.
That's the way it'll stay,
with the real thing.
With the real thing. In perfect harmony,
perfect harmony,
a song of peace that echoes on and never goes away. Put your hand in my hand, let's begin today. With your hand in my hand, help me find a way. See the world for once, all standing hand in hand.
Clap your hands
and hear them echo through the hills for peace throughout the land. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony,
perfect harmony.
A song of peace that echoes on and never goes away. It's the real thing, what the world wants today.
That's the way it'll stay.
That's the way it'll stay,
with the real thing.
With the real thing.
One more time.
It's the real thing.
Yes, it is.
What the world wants today, that's the way it'll stay.
Before I introduce this next act, I thought I'd tell you a little bit about some of my travels. But I'm traveling. I just finished a wonderful tour of the Antarctica. No, I did, with my wife. 6 days and no nights. And I'll tell you, It is wonderful. Then we went down to the Canary Islands. Anybody ever been to the Canary Islands? You know there's no canaries on the Canary Islands? This is history. No canaries on the Canary. Then we went to the Virgin Islands. There's no canaries there either. Weird. Okay. Here's a wonderful group who started in Seattle, BS. That's before Starbucks. And they've been great. They're still fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, the Brothers Four.
I have been a bold deceiver, a vow to make me living with me pistol and me rapier. I don't know what I've stolen, but would make a pretty penny. Then I lost it all to me darling sporting Jenny.
I'm a sheringham durham da, quack fall the daddy-o, quack fall the daddy-o, there's a whiskey in the jar.
Colonel Farrell up on Gilgaram out, took the gold to Ginny just to help me with the cap. Ginny called the guards and I never saw that many. I almost lost my freedom to my darling sporting Ginny.
I'm a sheringham durham down, whack fall the daddy-o, whack fall the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar.
I'd like to find me brother, he's the one who's in the army. I don't know where he's stationed, be it Cork or in Killarney. Together we'll go roaming through the mountains of Kilkenny. I swear he'll treat me fairer than my darling sporting Jenny.
Musharingam durum da, whack fall the daddy-o, whack fall the daddy-o, there's a whiskey in the jar.
Was early in the morning at the barracks of Killarney. My brother took his leave, but he didn't tell the army. Our horses, they were speedy, was all over but the shouting.
Now we went for Farrell upon Gilgarry Mountain. Musharingham durham da, back fall the daddy-o, back fall the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar. Musharingham durham da, back fall the daddy-o, back fall the daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar. Musharingham durham da, back fall the daddy-o, back fall the daddy-o, there's a whiskey in the jar.
You know, none of this would happen without all of the volunteers, the enthusiasm from the, all the WFMA volunteers. Thank you, guys. And Mr. Dick Serry right over there. Thank you, Dick.
Without Dick Serry, this doesn't happen, right?
We're glad Ronnie Shell is here, too. It's great to see Ronnie. We just want to remind you quickly of names and faces here of our group, in case you brought old album covers. The ones with the pictures of our sons on them. You know those, Rob. Over here, living in Seattle now, born in Minnesota, from Minneapolis, say hello to Mr. Mark Pearson on the far end. From the fabulous city of Minot, North Dakota.
No, Minot.
He plays the mandolin, he plays the six string. This is Terry Lauber right here. Say hello to Terry. And And here he is from a little town. I just love saying the name of this town. He comes from a little Indian town in Washington State. It's called Wenatchee.
Wenatchee.
Yeah. Wenatchee. You know where Wenatchee is?
The apple capital of the world.
It's the what?
Apple capital of the world.
Big damn deal.
Yeah.
We sometimes like to say this is the original Greenfields guitar. It actually is. And this is the original Mr. John Payne right here. Say hello. I want to say thanks. Mary, you're in the house. Thanks for letting us use the bass this week. My name is Bob Flick, and once again, thank you all for letting us be here with you.
With memories for us. This is just fabulous. We're seeing people we haven't seen for a long, long time. We're seeing performers and singers and players that we haven't seen for a while. This is it's like a once-in-a-lifetime deal. This is great. Great for all of us to experience it.
This train don't carry the gamblers of this train. This train don't carry the gamblers of this train. This train don't Cheaters, not our midnight rambler. This train don't carry no gamblers of this train.
This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, don't carry nothing but the righteous and the holy. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train.
Rockin' line is a mighty good road.
Rockin' line is a road to ride.
A
rock a little light is a body good road. And if you want to ride, I got a straddle like a fly. And get your ticket at the station on the rock a little light. A, B, C, W, X, Y, Z. That cat's in the couple, but he don't see. Now the rock a little light is a body good road. The rock a little light is a road to ride. Rock on the line is a mighty good road. And if you want to ride, I got a straddle like a fly. Get your ticket at the station on the rock on the line.
Yes, if you want
to ride, I got a straddle like a fly. Get your ticket at the station on the rock island
Magic Night. We thank you all for being here. We're going to do just a couple of tunes before the Kingston Trio comes out.
Just so that you will know, because I know you see at least one strange face up here, we do have, as you obviously can see, both Rick and Bill from the Limelighters. On the far left, Mark Pearson from the Brothers Four. And there's two strange faces, maybe. David Peel used to play with Bob Shane about 30 years ago in a group called the Shane Gang. So David, part of this family. And as all of us are members of the Kingston Trio family in a musical way, one of my dearest friends in the whole world, who is a musician extraordinaire in New York City, and is leading the cause for the new country wave of music up there, Mr. Buddy Woodward. Mike.
One of the most amazing bass players I have ever met, Mr. Paul Gabrielson.
More about that later.
When I'm gone, well, I know you, rider, gonna miss me. When
Now one of the moments we've all been waiting for, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm going to introduce them as I did 43 years ago. I know you've heard this if you have College Concert album, made back in 61 or 2, I don't remember. But just for some nostalgic reasons, I'll do it again. Okay, here we go. Three men of who I've had the pleasure of working with off and on for the last 43 years. I love the way they sing. They like the way I do their shirts. Ladies and gentlemen, the Kingston Trio.
First song we recorded in 1923. Wonderful. Well, thank you. Wonderful little ditty entitled Three Jolly Coachmen. Whatever jolly meant in those days.
Flowing bowl until it doth run over.
Land the bill of flowing bowl until it doth run over.
Bowl tonight, when there I be.
Bowl tonight, when there I be. Bowl tonight, when there I be.
Tomorrow we'll be sober.
I'll be a song.
Here's to the man who drinks dark ale and goes to bed quite mellow.
Here's to the man who drinks dark ale and goes to bed quite mellow.
He lives as he ought to live.
Lives as he ought to live. Lives as he ought to live.
And dies a jolly good fellow.
Here's to the man drinks water pure and goes to bed quite sober.
Here's to the man drinks water pure and goes to bed quite sober.
He falls as the leaves do fall.
Falls as the leaves do fall. Falls as the leaves do fall.
He'll die before October.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and runs to tell her mother.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and runs to tell her mother.
She's a foolish, foolish thing.
She's a foolish, foolish thing.
She's a foolish, foolish thing. For she'll not get another.
Pity.
Oh well.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and stays to steal another.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and stays to steal another.
Oh, could he?
She's a boon to all mankind.
She's a boon to all mankind. She's a boon to all mankind. For she'll soon be a mother.
Whenever the rights of men have been threatened, today, a new crisis has arisen. The Metropolitan Transit Authority, better known as the MTA, is attempting to levy a burdensome tax on the population in the form of a subway fare increase. Citizens, hear me out. This could happen to you.
Tell you of a story of a man named Charlie on a tragic and fateful day. He put 10 cents in his pocket, kissed his wife and family, went to ride on the MTA.
Oh, did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever neath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returned.
Charlie handed in his dime at the Kendall Square station, then he changed for Jamaica Plain. When he got there, the conductor told him one more nickel, Charlie couldn't get off of that train.
But did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unclear.
Oh, Charlie,
he may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returned.
Now all night long, Charlie rides through the station crying, what will become of me? How can I afford to see my sister in Chelsea or my cousin in Roxbury?
But did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned.
He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returned. Now Charlie's wife goes down to the Scully Square station every day at 2:15. And through the open window she hands Charlie a six-pack as the train goes rumbling up the
distance. But if he ever returned, no, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned.
Get thirsty,
he may ride forever neath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returned.
Make it, George.
Hi, guys. Watch his fingers, folks.
Absolutely amazing. He must have learned that at Juilliard.
Backyard.
All you citizens of Boston, don't you think it's a scandal how the people have to pay and pay? Bite the fairy priest, vote for George O'Brien, get poor Charlie off the MTA.
Or else he'll never return, no, he'll never return, and his fate will be unlearned. He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston, he's a man. He's a man who never returned. He's a man who never returned.
Hey, too, Charlie.
For B, his words.
Let me introduce you to the boys. Bob Hayworth, we first met back in the 70s. He was a member of the Brothers Four for 15 years. He quit them in 85 and joined us, then we were even. He played from 85 to 88 with us until Nick Reynolds came after a 21-year layoff, came back for 10 years. Retired in 99, and Bobby Hayworth came back again. He's a wonderful musician. He'll tell you so himself. And a very dear friend for a long time. Mr. Bob Hayworth. Paul Gabrielson played for 12 years with us, and then he took off for 3 years to play jazz in France, but France had moved. And they went to Argentina or someplace. And just by chance, when Ben Schubert just recently, who had been with us for 27 years, said he couldn't take it anymore, he wanted to go paint his house. But the same day, Paul called up and said, hey, have you got a gig available? And so this is the way this thing works with us. It just happens. It's like finding a parking place in front, you know. It's just, what do you do? So this guy is a musical historian. He reminds us all the things we should remember about this historical part of the music business. Simple things like the difference between a violin and a viola is the viola burns longer. Things like the best way to keep two flutists playing in tune together is to shoot one. And the definition of perfect pitch, being able to throw a banjo down a mine shaft and miss all the accordions. Our good buddy for a long time now, Mr. Paul Gabrielson on bass. I'd like to have you meet a guy, this guy right here. Did we introduce Paul all right?
Yeah.
Okay, sometimes I forget, you know.
And they don't make Viagra for the brain.
No. Yeah. Kid asked me if I had to try Viagra. I told him the truth. Viagra for me would be like putting a brand new flagpole on a condemned building. They found a good use for it. They give it to old guys at old folks' homes. Keeps them from rolling out of bed at night.
So that's why you look so rested.
Very
today,
rested,
you know?
Yes.
Took two.
Okay. George joined the group 27 years ago, the first guy to sing with this group who majored in music. He majored in piano and trumpet. It's really been handy. A product of the Nashville School, he has been a producer, director, singer, picker, engineer, male model, and pimp. Shrimp, I'm sorry. I would like to have you meet a man who certainly, above all else, needs absolutely no introduction whatsoever.
Thank you. A lot of us gathered here this evening thinking about the Kingston Trio and the years, the almost 45 years in June that the Kingston Trio has been outperforming. And I would just like to peruse some thoughts that are kind of commingled in my brain. And those thoughts include David Buckwheat, Dean Riley, Stan Case, Roger Gamble, and David Gard. One of the aspects of the Kingston Trio that has meant the most to me over the years is the unbelievably wide variety of songs that were recorded, especially in the early history of the group. And one of the guys who had the unique capacity to find these sometimes weird and strange, but always entertaining songs was John's and my mentor, Dave Gard. This song is one of those that he found. It's a song that contains in its lyrics an element of mystery and romance and intrigue. And in the music, the sounds of Baja California. It's called Mission San Miguel. By the Mission San Miguel is a great house wherein dwell Don Carlos and La Doña Maria Elena Cantrell. I work at the ranch, I saddle her mare, I ride with a gun behind as she visits her friends here and there. She says, thank you, Manuel. Oh, Manuel, por favor. Or good evening, Manuel. La Doña Maria Elena Cantrell. I dream of the mission San Miguel, and it says to me, the mission bell, she is married, Manuel. The wife of the rancher Don Carlos Cantrell. You serve at the ranch, you hold her chair, you carry her boxes, trunks, letters and books here and there. She says, thank you, Manuel. Oh, Manuel, por favor. Oh, good evening, Manuel. La Doña Maria Elena Cantrell. But I hear with my heart what she says with her eyes. She says, thank you, Manuel. Oh, Manuel, por favor. Or the carriage, Manuel. Oh, Manuel, close the age. But we grew up in the 50s and the 60s listening to the songs of the Kingston Trio, and we learned every banjo part, every guitar part, every single song, all almost 400 songs. And it served us fairly well today because we never rehearse. Except we did on this one just a little bit.
Well, we put in a little time on this because, well, we've had a lot of requests for some of these songs, and particularly this song, some people came up last night and tonight and said, please do this, please, please. So we're going to honor those requests, and we've got several $100 bills to reflect those requests. So we figured we better get this in tonight. So for all of those who have been itching, dying, waiting to hear this song, here it is.
Sail up all the time. cries of war. Tell not a soul that you have seen me, breathe not a word of what I say. Tell not a soul that you have seen me, breathe not a word of what I say.
There have been many requests for the next presentation. A more talented man I couldn't find, and a dearer friend I couldn't find. Bob Hayworth.
This evening I'm going to play a rather unusual folk instrument. Many of you have seen one of these hanging around your garage, perhaps. It's called a saw. Some of the younger people have never seen a hand tool before on the show. So I have to kind of explain this to them. Has no power cord attached. This one's actually an acoustic saw. But my great-grandfather gave me this saw when I was about 12, and he said, Bobby, I hope you make good use of this saw. So, well, I don't think he had this in mind exactly. Here's a quick little example of what you can do with tools around your house.
Throughout history, there have been many songs written about the Bermuda Triangle. This song tells the story of a Mr. Grayson, a beautiful woman, and a condemned man named Tom Dooley. When the sun rises tomorrow, Tom Dooley must hang.
Hang down your head, Tom.
Sing it out.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Oh boy, you're bound to die. I met her on the mountain. There I took her life. Met her on the mountain. Stabbed her with my knife. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Oh boy, you're bound to die. It's time tomorrow. Reckon where I'll be. Hadn't have been for Grayson, I'd have been in Tennessee. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley, hang down your head.
I be, down in some lonesome valley, hanging from a white oak tree. Hang down your head, Tom, to the knee. Hang down your head and cry, boy. Well, hang down your head, Tom, to the knee. Oh boy, you're bound to die. Oh well, now, boy, hang down your head.
The song Tom Dooley sold more records than any other recording of the Kingston Trios throughout its history. That's true. But the song that was most often requested, and still throughout the history of this group is most often requested, you got it. It was never sung by the Kingston Trio as a group. It was sung by Bob Shane, all by himself.
Scotch and soda, mud in your eye. Baby, do I feel I'll be, oh my. Do I feel high? Try martini, ginger and gin. Oh, what a spell you got me in. Oh my, do I feel high? People won't believe me. They'll think that I'm just bragging, that I could feel the way I do and still be on the wagon. All I need is one of your smiles, the sunshine of your eyes on me. Oh my, do I feel higher than a kite can fly? Get me loving, baby, I feel high.
That's a great old song. We have a little finale sort of set up after this, and we'd like to do one song that we've had many requests for this evening. It's a closer we've used for many years, written by a real hobo who inadvertently stole the music from the Land of Milk and Honey, got sued and lost the song, but not before you got a big yellow Cadillac convertible. And they say that in the hobo jungles outside of Chicago after that, you could see all these hobos just laying around in this big old yellow Cadillac convertible. Isn't that cute?
Well, no matter where I wander, I know I'll always find the welcome. At the end of every journey, there'll be friendly people. California would not hold me, though I love her timbered mountains, her fields and worked her orchards, up and down her central valley.
I have driven open highways across the golden Utah Valley, and I watched the rivers gently gliding. I wave a hand.
California would
timbered mountains, worked her fields and worked her orchards, up and down her central valley. Folks who know me call me a drifter. They don't think I'll stop my rambling. They don't know that someday,
someday,
somewhere somebody gonna make me settle down.
I'm going home, Lord, I'm going home. I'm going home, Lord, I'm going home.
Well, no matter where I wander, I know I'll always find a welcome. At the end of every journey, there'll be friendly people waiting. California would not hold me, though I love her timbered mountains, worked her fields and worked her orchards, up and down her central valley. But going home.
God bless you. Thank you very much. Bring these people on here. Come on. Have the whole crew come out here. Let's do something. Let's fall on our knees.
That Buffy song that we, one night we were playing a concert in Boston in the early 1960s, and The promoter of the concert owned a club in downtown Boston, and he invited the three of us, me and Nick and John, to go down to hear this fantastic new group he had. And it turned out to be Peter, Paul, and Mary. And we invited them back to our hotel afterwards, and we immediately sent Peter and Paul out for ribs. Because they knew where to get them. And Mary taught us this song.
Long time passing, where all
one. When will they ever learn? When will they ever learn? This land is your land. This land is my land.
On the sparkling sand of your time in the desert, and all around me a voice kept sounding.
This land was made for you and me. This land is your land. This land.
Brothers, the Brothers Four, the Limeliners, the Incontinence, the